Testes. One, two, testes. One, two. All right, we're going to get in the mix with another of Soul Jack DJs. We got Mel Rosario in the house. You ready? Hey, you know what? Ray Martinez, I'm going to kill you. We'll be right back.
get up. About to 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 get up. This is my stop.
Does it come as a surprise that I rise? That I dance? As if I have diamonds at the meeting of my thighs. Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past rooted in pain, I rise. A black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in time. Does it come as a surprise that I rise? That I dance? As if I have diamonds at the meeting of my thighs. Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past rooted in pain, I rise. A black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide.
ladies and gentlemen. That was an awesome set by our guy, Mel Rosario.
Thank you. Yeah.
Hey, man, thanks for coming aboard to our show, coming out here and doing your thing. Awesome set. Nice set.
Thank you.
You know, just like TCB. He did an awesome set. You did an awesome set. Great. You guys all threw down. A little bit about yourself and your whole Soul Jack thing. How long have you been mixing?
Over 25 years.
You're an old school.
I got into it, first DJ Sneak record, Work It.
Ah, DJ Sneak.
Yeah, when he started that whole filter house.
That's one of the cats from Chicago that made it out of here, and thank God he's successful. Have you been producing for as long or equivalent to...
Producing, my first project came out in 07, but I've been, working on music since like maybe 18. So, yeah, it's been a journey.
Of the tracks that you played today your own tracks?
No, honestly, it's taboo playing my own stuff.
Really?
I'd rather play other people's stuff.
You're just like TCB.
Yeah, I'd rather play other people's stuff, you know.
Yeah, so that's cool. I mean, whatever you're comfortable with.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just, you know, you'd like to hear some of your stuff. But then again, you have a lot of tracks out there or what?
Yeah, I got a lot of EPs out there. The latest one I'm going to be releasing on Soul Jack Digital. It was a project I did probably like a few years ago. I finally finished it. So that one's going to be released on Soul Jack.
How's that coming along? How long have you been Soul Jack?
Actually, me and Tony go way back. We were actually talking about starting Soul Jack. That's how I was pretty much in the beginning of Soul Jack.
Really?
Then I went and did my own thing, you know. For a while, then I came back. So I was pre-Soul Jack.
Okay. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And now, anything you want to let the fans know about what's... Any new plans with Soul Jack? Anything that you want, you know...
Well, actually...
Besides the spring album that's coming out?
Yeah, that's coming out. Basically, it's just now that we're putting out music, actually, we're just trying to look for artists now, you know. People who are coming up or who wants to, you know, start up. So that's pretty much my focus right now.
Okay.
You know, so.
Do you have any residencies?
No, it's been years. Been years since Zentra days. I used to do VIP room with Tony, Carlos, Disco. I don't know if you remember Disco back in the day. Yeah. But that was the last time. But nah, I'm a family man. I stay home.
That's what we do here.
We're
I don't know if they told you, but when you come down here, you could bring your family. This is a family oriented place. Happy wife, happy life type of deal.
Yeah.
Because if the wife don't support you, you ain't going that far. Especially if you're not single. So
yeah.
We do good, you know.
Yeah.
How was your experience here today?
Actually, I loved it, man. That setup in there you got is a whole different energy in there. But yeah, it's a really good setup.
Yeah, we try to have every base covered because you never know who's gonna come down here as a guest.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times different legends walk in here and just hang out with us, and it could be during your day, it could not, and you meet interesting people here.
Yeah.
But again, it's just a bunch of us with the same passion, and we love the music thing and blending and so forth, and playing tracks and our own tracks. And as we do that, we our goal is to give a show every Sunday that's positive to all the fans out there globally.
Yeah.
So it's not about I'm gonna piss on the next show. He's gonna piss on me. We're competing, and none of that crap. It's just about, hey man, you do what you have to do. We do what we have to do. We do the best that we can do, and hopefully it's good enough.
Yeah.
You know.
Exactly.
You know, we showcase from other shows and so forth, whatever it takes. As far as wow, so you've been with Soul Jack since the beginning. Probably like one of the oldest members, right?
Yeah, pretty much so. Actually, with Tony, we were talking about it some years ago, and then he actually got it together, so.
Okay. What? Where can the fans hear more about your music?
Actually, if you go on TrackSource, I have a catalog on TrackSource. So okay. If you search Mel Rosario, my whole catalog will come up. So I got remixes. EPs from 07, Juno too. Juno actually carries all the old stuff from like 07, so.
Okay.
If you want to hear the old stuff.
Any mixes out there, SoundCloud or whatnot?
I only got one mix on SoundCloud. Actually, I'm going to be making mixes for the Soul Jack I'm gonna start making for the podcast too, so you guys can download the mixes too. So,
okay.
I'm getting back into mixing. It's been a while, man. You know, so.
What do you usually like mix at home?
Turntables. I actually I'm more of a vinyl guy, so I don't really own a pair of CDJs. You know.
You know, I owned them. I can probably count the times I went on them.
Yeah.
Because I like doing the vinyl thing, and it's a challenge, you know. You control that record. Sometimes you went in too fast, you got to slow it down. Sometimes you didn't go in fast enough, you got to speed it up. Sometimes you mess up on the whole video thing, but you did it live, and I can respect somebody that did it live than somebody who did it edited, pre-recorded, and he hit all that, and he fixed all that. So, you know, I like the turntable thing myself. You can see I've got the 12s, I've got the Pioneers, I got them both. You know, I try this one and that one, and whichever works best. I can't speak for everyone else. I mean, if you're a controller guy, I respect you. I use controllers when I'm doing mobile gigs.
Yeah.
And I'm a fan of the controller when it comes to that, because it's smart not to drag all that stuff. But in my studio.
Those Pioneers, I mean the CDJs?
Oh, the CDJs are very sweet.
I'm not a big fan of DJing on CDs, but it was
experience. They're very sweet. Yeah. I guess I'd rather mess with the vinyl and train myself. So when you get on the CDJs, you're on point.
Yeah.
You know? And again, that's just how it is. It's just on a record, you know, you get that lap. And you're constantly playing with the pitch, writing it. On a CDJ, if you have it on the money, it stays on the money for whatever point. And if you have to slow down or speed up, you can use the outer jog wheel and then adjust your pitch. You know. It is what it is. It's fun. No matter what you're mixing on, if you got them dancing and you're playing some positive tracks, it's all good with me. I don't care if you're...
Like I said earlier, just give me... give me two tape decks with a pitch and I'll just mix on that.
Oh, my God. Tape deck with a pitch, dude. It's going to be a lot of hissing. But hey, I hear you.
Yep.
You know? I never got to mix on those.
No? It was pretty horrible.
I remember CDs came out with pitch and I had the new mic that... The controller was on top and you hit eject and the bottom opens up on the amp rack.
Yeah.
And the fact that I had pitch, I was smiling because I was able to mix CDs, my Spanish, which didn't come on vinyl. So that was awesome, you know?
Yeah.
But hey man, anything else you want to tell the audience?
Oh, well, thank you for listening. Probably this year I'm gonna be making more mixes, pretty much coming back, you know, getting into the whole scene again. So I'm going to be working on some new projects, too, so...
Hey, that's awesome. We'll see, yeah. Keep us in the loop, you know?
Yeah, for sure.
You know, Tony's one of us, so, you know, all that'll work out. Any shout-outs to anyone out there?
Oh, pretty much everyone, man. Everyone who listened, everyone who supported me throughout the years, too. I'm really grateful. You know, I had a good run, and I'm going to have a longer run, too, until... Me pongo viejo.
You know, even after that, if we chair ourselves to the decks, we're still going to make it happen.
Oh, yeah, for sure. So, yeah, I'm pretty much everyone who supported me through the years, you know. So.
That's awesome, man. I'm glad I met you and you came out.
All right, you too, man. I had a good time.
You know, again, everybody, like I keep saying, tune in every Sunday, 5 to 9 Central Standard Time, p.m. Here on the Music Workshop, Global Music DJs in the house, www.globalmusicdjs.com. That's where you can find us. Every Sunday, we have a different show, a different guest, a different member. You know, we rotate and have fun. This is about having fun.
Yeah, unity. So everybody, too,
again, you know, Soul Jack Digital. Up next, we're going to have a few more interviews with a couple of other Soul Jackers. So stay tuned.
All right, see you later.
Peace out.